स्टैंडर्ड 8 सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 2 एनवायरमेंटल पोल्यूशन पार्ट 3 द लास्ट मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट विच अफेक्ट्स एडवर्सली टू द लाइफ पीपल्स लाइफ इज नॉइज पोल्यूशन। एयर एंड वाटर पोल्यूशन आर विजिबल बट नॉइज पोल्यूशन हैज इंक्रीज्ड एज वेल। The noise created by the machines in industries, vehicles, is very loud. During the festivals and celebrations, loudspeakers, DJ bands, etc. are used at great volume. This creates noise pollution. Noise pollution is also created by playing musical instruments loudly or by bursting noisy firecrackers at the time of celebration of any festivals, victory in any game, or elections. These all are the time when we are using different types of noises to show our emotions. The city has maximum number of buses, rickshaws, and two-wheelers. Haphazard parking leads to congestion of vehicles. The subsequent blowing of horns created noise pollution. In traffic, people are using horns non-stop to make their way to reach their destination. This also creates noise pollution. Noise pollution leads to defense and affects mental and emotional health also. People get irritated through continuous noise and it affects their emotions. Nature is affected badly due to noise. Certain insects and organisms that are very helpful to us die due to loud noises. It has become necessary to keep signboards reading "No honking" or "Silence please" near schools, dispensaries, hospitals, etc. You can see these types of boards near your school or near any clinic or medical clinic or hospital. When you go to your school or any hospital, pay attention to the notice boards which is written that school is near, so please don't walk. These types of boards are shown at each and every school, hospitals and medical clinic. This shows the seriousness of noise pollution. It is very important that citizens themselves understand about it. We should not play musical instruments loudly during celebrations or special occasions. We should not burst firecrackers producing loud noise. Vehicles should be sent for servicing at proper intervals so it cannot produce noise. Rules regarding PUC must be made strict. Population increase must be controlled to reduce the noise pollution. Trees should be planted on both the sides of the roads and around industries. The road should be broad enough so that traffic problems should not arise. Awareness and appropriate actions is the need of the hour to save ourselves from pollution. We all are aware how valuable the water is. Still, while purchasing the bottle of mineral water, we do not realize its importance. In ancient times, people were drinking water from lakes, wells, and rivers freely. They do not have to pay. But in today's life, we are paying the price for the water bottle. This shows how important water is for us and how much we have polluted water. There is scarcity of water on earth. Today, pure water is not the only concern. Gandhiji had said that water, land and forest belongs to the community. Therefore, we can enjoy it equal right. But today we are selling these commodities because it is scarce and It is needed by each and every person living on this. The moral seed is to make the community for self. Man-made problems, water pollution holds the highest priority. We have to find an answer to it. And this responsibility has to be shared equally by everybody. If we are enjoying the products equally, then we have to save the product equally. It is a responsibility for each and every citizen of the country to save water, to save land, and to save air, and to use it in judicious way. Every person has to understand his own responsibility and has to find various measures to make our environment cleaner and healthier. These are the slogans of social awareness which are used for stopping the pollution on the earth. Be a compassionate citizen. That means we have to pay whatever we get. Save the environment and environment will save us. If we save water, then water will save us. If we save land, then they will save us. If we save trees, then trees will save us. And last is save animals. If there are animals, there are forests. If there are forests, there are trees. And if there are trees, there is pure air and oxygen to inhale and to sustain our. Therefore, each and every living organism on this earth are interconnected to each other. We have to save them to save ourselves. This chapter is completed and you have to write all the questions regarding this chapter in your work. Next, we will start chapter number 3 in our next video. Thank you.